So today we're going to discuss a problem in which we need to calculate the height of a binary tree. So let's say this is a binary tree in which this particular node is a root and these are its two child nodes. So if we need to calculate the height of it, it will be 1. So always remember, the height of a binary tree is always equal to the longest path from the root to any leaf node. Let's take another example. So this is a root node and these are its child node. Now we extend further one of its child node to have more child nodes. Now height of the binary tree will be 2, which is this path along with this or either this, which makes it total 2. Let's take one more example. So this is a root node. Now we have right node, which is a child of root node. Again we have another right node and again. Now the height of this particular binary tree is 3. So we started from the root node and we just calculated the longest depth from the root node to reach any of its leaf node. In case if there is only one node, which is a root node itself, in this case the height will be 0. Now let's see like how we can solve this particular problem. So we will take another binary tree. So we will start from its root node and start going to its left nodes or subtrees. So we keep on incrementing the height. So initial height will be 0. So we will increment its height to 1 when it first go to its left child node. And so on to 2. Now on its way back, like while returning from the recursive function, it will return the maximum height so far it able to find from its left subtree. So at this particular point, the height, the maximum height it was able to get was 2. Now let's move to its right child node to see if we can able to find height greater than 2. So we increment height to 1 and as there is no other child nodes, so it will again return from that recursive call and the maximum height so far we are able to get is 1 from the right subtree. So we can say the height of this particular subtree is 2. So this is a code implementation for finding the height of any binary tree. So in this function find height, we will take two parameters. One is the root node, or we can say the tree node, and the height. So if the node is null, let's say like you have not provided any root node at all, so the height will be 0 for that case. Now you will start going to the left node or left child of the root node if the root node is not null, and you again call the same function with the new node, that is node left, and you will increment the height. Same you will do for the right node, and you will again call the function, you will pass the right node and increment the height. So at the end you will return the maximum height so far. So you will go to the left, you will go to the right, and you will see like which one is the maximum height. So you keep on returning those height from any subtree you visit. So at the end of this all recursive call, you will get the height of this binary tree. So now we will just do a dry run for this particular implementation, and we will also have a pictorial representation of this particular binary tree. So for this binary tree, we need to calculate the height. So we are sitting at the root node and the height is 0. Now we start going to left and we increment its height to 1. So when we are sitting at this particular position, and we have no left node and we have no right node to it. So we will return the maximum height. So in this case, it will be 1. So height till now is 1. Now the interesting part. Now we will start moving to the right. And now we are sitting here. At this particular position, the height we have calculated so far is 1. Now at this particular point, we will go to its left and see its height. So we will increment the height so far we have till this point. Currently, like, we are sitting on this particular node and we have height so far 1. So while going to its left node, we will increment its height to 2. And we have no left node and no right node for this particular node, which is a leaf node of this particular tree. So we will return to from here. So at this particular root node, the height so far we are able to get is 2. Now we will go to its right and the same thing follows. So far we are able to get the maximum height 2. Now from this particular node, we will return this maximum height so far we are able to find, which is also the maximum depth. Now we will compare it with the height which we got from the left subtree and the height which we got from the right subtree. So the height will be 2.